Good morning. Here we are in the local butcher shop again, and I want to introduce you to a very important tool for any butcherman. The most important tool a butcherman can have, or a butcher woman nowadays, there actually are a lot more women coming in our trade than men, and that's a good thing, is a knife. A quality knife. There is nothing worse than working with a knife that's of a bad quality, can't hold an edge, or is made up just badly, isn't comfortable in your hand and nothing. And I am a butcher now for just over 50 years. Yes, I am 67 years old and I am still working every day in the butcher shop, simply because I enjoy it. But regardless, so for 50 years I worked with just about every brand of knife there is out there. And I am not a person who promotes a product just for the sake of promoting a product. I have to be convinced. But if I'm convinced about a product, I feel almost obliged to pass it on. And in this case, it's butcher knives. And like I said, I worked with just about any brand of butcher knives out there, and high-end brands. You know, a tool for me has to last a long time. On top of that, it has to do what I demand of it to do, and flawlessly. Like I said before, for me there's nothing worse than a knife that can't hold an edge. I have thrown good quality knives, major brands, away in the garbage because I was sick and tired of sharpening it every day after work, because it couldn't, for some reason, it just couldn't hold an edge. And talking about edge, I have a video. You have to look down in my list, and there is a video how to sharpen knives and how to keep them sharp. So let me introduce you, like 6 months ago, or maybe almost a year now actually, Aaron Waters from America introduced me to Victory knife. Different, don't make a mistake, it's Victory knife, not Victorinox. Victory knife. They are made in New Zealand. And they introduced me to, and I bought a knife or two just because, you know, I wanted to try out something new, and so why not give it a shot, try it out. After working a week with these two knives, I retired my entire line of knives and ordered a complete set for the butcher shop here to cut meat and so forth, and a complete set to slaughter animals from Aaron Waters. And because he is the American, he's a butcher himself and a slaughterman, but also the salesman for Victory knives from New Zealand in America. I will post a link to, for those that are interested, or in your comments you can ask, and I will put it on for you. So anyway, let me introduce you to these knives. So here we are. This is the knife. This is my steak knife. See here, Victory knife, New Zealand. And I really don't know how they manufacture. I don't know what steel they use for these knives, but believe me, this particular knife I cut steaks with every single day. Hundreds of steaks. I have sharpened it once a week, and it's still as sharp as a razor blade, exactly the way they should be. Once a week. All the knives I have from Victory are like that. And here is what they look like. Let me adjust the camera so I can introduce you to my set of knives. So here they are. That's the one you just saw. That's my other steak knife, also called a scimitar, that I use to break down beef carcasses with. And like I said, I don't know what steel they're made of, but I personally, I never had a knife made with a steel like that is just phenomenal. They hold an edge, they're not too hard, they're not too soft, they're just right where they need to be. And I think after 50 years working with so many knives, my opinion counts for something when it comes to knife quality. This is my breaking knife, also for beef and for hawks and all other animals. And what I like about their knives is, look at this here. Some of them, they have these ripples here. All my slaughter animals have these ripples here. They're not hard, they're not too soft either, but when you hold the knife, it's like glued to your hand. And here on the block for cutting meat, it's not so a big deal. But when you slaughter animals, your hands are constantly either bloody or full of fat and slippery, and this knife does not slip out of your hand, no way. And then they have a bigger hook down here too. See, there's a bigger hook, so that's always my fear by many other knives, that you can slip a bit and slip right onto the blade, and then you go to the doctor and need your finger stitched up. This is actually a very common accident with butchers, that they slip and then cut their finger. And then they have other knives too. This one, it says Pro Grip on it. That too, it's not too soft. Some of them have very soft grips, and I don't like that. I don't like to grab like a sponge. But it's not rock hard either, and it's all rough, a little bit like, almost like sandpaper. And the same thing, it can't slip out of your hand. And everything is just perfect. See, for the thumb here, you can hold it any which way, and it fits perfectly. It fits perfectly in my palm here, see? It's just phenomenal. It's a dream to work with these knives. I get very quickly angry if a knife doesn't do what I want it to do, or how, if the quality is not. And like I said, for 50 years I looked for the perfect butcher tool. And with these Victory knives, I found that tool. I will use these knives till the day I have to quit or die, whatever comes first. So if you look into quality knives, and I'm not getting paid to say this, like I said before, this is my honest professional opinion. There are no better butcher knives. Believe me, I worked with over 15, 20 brands of knives, and I'm not going to mention them here, but the top brand from Germany, from America, from England. I always looked for the perfect knife. With Victory knives from New Zealand, I found them. So, if you look for a quality knife, contact this firma. So, like I said below, I'm going to leave a link to the company. They also have a YouTube channel. And for Aaron Waters, he is on Facebook. I'm going to leave a link down there for you Americans. Butchers, you can contact him. And believe me, like I said before, I'm not getting paid to do that. That's my service to fellow tradesmen out there. If you look for a proper knife, you know, a proper tool makes life so much easier. You know, a common problem with many butchers is they have wrist problems and they get a cramp in the fingers. And that comes from holding a knife that A, is not comfortable, or B, that you have to force all day long. Here it's not too bad, okay? Because here I take maybe one or two beef carcasses apart in a day. But like for these butchers that work in what I call meat factories, they take about 50 beef carcasses apart. And then each one does another cut, but they've been all day, but they've been at it with their knives, and at the end of the day, their wrist hurts. And I think most of the time, because for me it was the same thing, when I slaughter or when I skin animals, it was the same thing. At the end of the day, my hand, my joints and my fingers, they would hurt because they're glued. You know, and then after a while you get lazy and think, not again sharpen my knife, or again I have to steal my knife. These Victory knives here, you never will have a problem with that. Like I said, this particular one, that's my breaking knife, every day, pigs, beef, I use it for everything. And I sharp it once a week. Before, with many other brands, I would sharpen them either every day after work or every 2 days. But this, honest to God, every week once, and they're at the end of the week as razor sharp as they have been at the beginning of the week. So I hope this information helps you, and if you like our channel, subscribe to it and pass it on to your friends and so forth. Then here on my channel, we try to provide professional information for the meat industry, for tradespeople, slaughtermen and butchers, and maybe I even expand later on for meat consumers, how to treat meat, to keep it fresh at home, how to cook meat and so forth. This channel is all gonna be about meat and the meat trade. So if you enjoy, please subscribe, and thank you for watching. Have a great day, and God bless you all.